If the sin is a human weakness and you committed it and you sought the forgiveness of Allah, isn't it a sign that you know one day I'm going to go back to Allah? When my eyes close, I'm going back to Allah. Do you know those who fear death so much are actually those who don't believe in the mercy of Allah? Because death is inevitable. It will overtake you and I. It has to come. Don't be frightened of it. You are going to a better place. Did you not seek the forgiveness of Allah? Let me give you one beautiful example. You see, I started off by saying there is good and bad. There are tyrants and there are good people who are upright and just. There are oppressors and there are those who stand firm upon justice, come what may, even if it is against themselves or their folks. One of the worst of the lot from the beginning of time to now was a man known as the Pharaoh. It is said perhaps that was Ramses II. This Pharaoh was so dangerous, he felt he was the Lord. He used to tell his people, "Oh my people," not just the ordinary ones, the cronies from amongst them. In the Arabic language, the term used is al-mala, al-mala, the top people, the officials.
وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرِي.
Fir'aun said to his cronies, "Oh my cronies, I don't know of any other god besides me for you guys to worship." لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. What type of arrogance? And he knew he was a human. He also had stomach problems now and again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. But this was the hierarchy that he decided to create because of an environment that continued over generations. When something continues to happen for more than a generation, the new generation considers it the norm. And they start thinking that's how it's supposed to be.